Did we do it?
I think we're live. Check the chat. Make sure that it's there. You're here. They're talking about weebs. This is working great.
They can't see us yet. They will be in a second.
Gotcha.
Alright, also something about Twitch, there's like a 20 second delay in between what they see and what we're doing here.
Yeah.
Just for things to be transmitted and all that stuff. Okay, things are loading.
You got a notification. We're live.
We're live!
Hey!
Welcome, guys. We should never hear this.
Why are we hearing double?
Creepy.
We have technical difficulties.
Of course. We knew this was happening. Turn off the audio from the cameras.
Yes.
That was what did it last time. It's so hard.
There's so many moving parts.
It's so hard.
Welcome everybody.
Hey!
But it's also crazy that we need to get close to doing this. That's the thing that blows my mind.
Well, that we live in a day and age where we're even close to doing this.
Yes.
Well, living in the future. Yes.
And kids in high school are light years ahead of us.
So we are using some sort of archaic interface where we're having such a hard time. For these guys, they just press a button and it all works. Okay, so that's doing it. We don't know if we're... At least we're transmitting, but it's double talk. That's the whole problem.
Keep talking.
All right, guys. We're at least just going to talk in double talk. My name is Ray Chase. I play Noctis in Final Fantasy. This is Keythe Farley, casting director and director for Final Fantasy XV and Thane Krios in Mass Effect. And Kellogg in Fallout 4.
Whoa.
And director of Skylanders. And voice of Scott Trade. And director of Rugrats. Writer, creator of Bat Boy the Musical. This is a storied man. He brought his ukulele with him today.
I did.
Keythe, say hi to everybody.
Hi, everybody.
We are excited to be here. We have technical difficulties.
We just fixed it. The microphone should be A-OK. And also, we have about 800 of you in the room right now.
Well, great. We don't have a controller. We don't have a controller today, but we will.
I got it.
Okay, great.
I'll use my brain. We have our mascot with us.
Hey.
Kappa.
Yay.
By the way, you guys, we just set up a lot of stuff. So you'll see in the below the stream.
That's adorable.
We set up our bio, our schedule. We'll add more dates as they come. And we also set up a donations tab. We'll never ask you guys for donations. All that is for us to get better equipment, better, camera stuff, microphone stuff, a better recording space. We're going to get a green screen eventually. It'll look awesome. So that's why that's there. And when you donate, you'll see Catbug. So
there we go. And I still have to watch this Bravest Warriors thing. I don't know the Catbug. He's a cool guy.
Yeah, oh, Catbug is the best. It's played by Sam Lavanino, who's... He might be like 9 years old now, but when he started, he was like six when he started recording. And it's the cutest voice in the world.
Hopefully he's kidding. Sam.
He has a different name.
No?
Sam Lavanino.
Yes.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Sam Lavanino.
Whoa. And he was on Time Magazine as like one of the smartest kids in the world, right?
Is he?
Hope told me that, yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's super cool.
He's a sharp kid.
So that's our mascot, and that's what you'll see when you press the donation button. We have 1,100 of you in the room. Super cool.
That's a mess of folks.
Thanks for coming, guys. So we are here to honor our guest, Keythe. What did you do? I thought it was gone for a second. We have been trying for, I think, a total of 6 weeks to, like, figure out what streaming is and how to do it. And we took all night Wednesday to set it all up. We did a practice. We bought some more equipment. Now I think we're ready to go. It's looking good. So tonight is here for Keythe. Ask Keythe questions. Keythe will tell stories and anecdotes from recording process, from the casting process. He will talk about what it was like to be a badass. To be the voice of Kernick's Oil and the Cup Noodle Salesman in Fallout or in Final Fantasy XV.
Good times.
Also tonight, we are going to play Fallout 4, which is a game that you've never played yourself.
I played through a little bit of it.
Oh, you did?
At the beginning, yeah. Created my character, went to the vault, got locked inside, came out on the PS4. But, you know.
It's almost the same thing.
I figured I came here tonight to humiliate myself.
I set up a character.
At least 1,100 people.
We also... So I set up a character who is... Oh wait, he's wearing glasses.
I like the glasses.
But I did base a character. Oh. Okay, we need to take off the sunglasses and let's take a look.
Ray, you're the master. I would rather just.
Well, if you were already able to, this is Kellogg. Kellogg is going to be played by Kellogg, and right now we are in Fort Hagen, ready to fight Kellogg. So you are going to hear your performance
all
the way through. If you can get all the way through.
I don't know that I can.
It's very easy. It should be fine. Your character's kind of at a decent level. I would like to see you try. It'd be really cool.
Like I said, I came to get humiliated.
Max, what are people saying? Is everything okay?
I literally cannot keep up.
How do you even...
Fabulous Kellogg, is the stream being saved? Yes.
Yes.
The stream is being archived. we quadruple checked. Don't worry.
Don't worry.
And then people are saying Kellogg-ception. They're saying...
Uh-oh.
I love Fallout.
Oh! Excuse me, sir. There's no performers allowed.
No. Somebody tackle the mime.
Sir, please. We did not order a mime. Oh, this
maybe
is
down the apart, down the somewhere else on the other floor.
really so good. this is mime Bozo the Robbie. Who's Marcel Mar Robbie?
Yes.
Damon Rabinowitz.
Oh my gosh.
For those of you who don't know, Robbie Damon. Robbie Damon has no voice. He lost his voice in a bout of coughing.
Maybe you should act out the story for us and we could just do a little.
Yes!
We could guess. Okay, Robbie, show us what happened. Where did it begin? He got a nasty cold.
Nasty cold.
I'll do Robbie. My voice!
And then he rested up, but nothing happened.
I don't feel very good.
And then
he died.
And that was that.
And he was reborn.
Reborn.
As Marcel Robbie.
Marcel Robbie.
Who is here. He is going to be doing the typing, the texting, the looking at the comments thing, and helping us with that sort of thing. Look at how good that makeup is.
It is really good.
Robbie, have you ever been a mime before? Yeah. Robbie has a master's degree in acting.
You are a mime. You had a little bit of mime training.
But that
you
makeup
get through
is really legit.
Conservatory without a little mime training.
It's very good.
I like the star on the left cheek.
Yes. And the tear on the right.
It's
perfect.
A little clasped. Because
you killed someone.
In prison.
It's a whole backstory. It's amazing.
Marcel Rabhi, the prison mime.
Prison mime?
It really is.
Oz 2.0.
Now, Robbie, you know sign language, correct? Yes, so Robbie knows sign. He will sign out comments that he enjoys.
Robbie, this is a family stream.
Oh, kids. Put the kids to bed. Robbie's in the house.
Robbie's on my computer, by the way. He's going to screw it up in the worst way. He'll give me 5 viruses by the end of the night.
Yep.
The chat, just so you guys know, is moving so quickly.
We can't read this.
How can we possibly read it?
This is insane. Okay.
Just go.
We're going to play, the game.
We're going to play, and Robbie's...
So are you going to coach me through this? Is that how this is going to work, or am I just on my own?
You've played this.
A little bit. There's the...
First I'll put it in first person for you. Yeah, there you go.
All
right. So right now, I already have a save. It's already saved. You're underneath where Kellogg is. Now, what we've done... this character, who looks exactly like you and acts exactly like you, and has the voice of
me.
No, not of you. This is who's the male?
Brian Delaney.
Brian T.
Yeah.
Delaney.
Yes. So he will not sound like you, unfortunately. But Rats. You are about to reach him. So unfortunately. But we can turn the music down and the voices up, so at least Kellogg can hear his
Great.
Kellogg. So I think that's something we would do. Look at you, you're a pro. You're doing great. You're already able to move around and look in a direction. This is so much further than a lot of people who've never played games before.
Hey, I started with Pong, dude.
So right now, the building you just came out of, so look back behind you.
And that was
you.
The last game I played.
Look behind you. That is where you need to go. So you need to go inside.
Upstairs.
That is a landmine that you just thankfully...
Sweet!
thankfully. So this is where Kellogg is. All the clues have led you to here, and you need to go inside and find Kellogg. Now, do you remember what Kellogg did and why we need to find him?
Barely. You tell me.
Kellogg is a mercenary.
Oh, sure, I know.
You know.
But I want to hear it from you.
Kellogg's a mercenary, and he killed your wife and
stole
your
baby. Yes, oh yeah, I was there for that.
Baby.
Yes.
You were there for that.
It was
the first thing that, one of the first things that happens in the game. Yeah, you're doing great. You actually go on top of the roof, and then there's a storm drain in there.
Storm drain?
Kellogg.
I killed the spouse and stole your baby. Is this going to be the setup where I have to, it's like radio, except that when you hear something, Robbie, okay, go back and say that again.
Robbie is so excited.
Because that's really fun.
Robbie has this, you know what, I'll let you discover it. But
yes.
But Robbie has some sounds.
Robbie did a little bit of stuff. So if you actually go, if you're able to get on top of this roof, there's
over here?
Storm drain. Yeah, on top, somewhere around here, there's a storm drain, and that's where you'll enter into this fort where Kellogg is holding himself up in.
The Institute.
Not the Institute yet.
Not yet.
Okay. So that's your pit boy, you know that.
Okay. And is there a leap
why
up there
is why is jump? Yeah.
To get up there to leap it.
Yeah. So there you go.
Alright. Something like running start. No, no, don't look down.
It might be a ramp.
That's
annoying. Yeah, I don't think you can jump. Oh, you did!
The hell I can.
Not bad.
Well, fourth try.
Somewhere up there is a storm drain on this roof of the fort, and you can go in there. You might be able to walk across these broken.
You think?
Yeah.
But I'm gonna end up back inside.
Well, but that's where you want to go. You want to go inside.
That was gonna be a little typo.
Rare. So we are looking to track down Kellogg and find him. Have you ever even seen this at all? Have you seen?
I've seen some of it. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I like to try to keep up on this.
Okay. Excellent.
Am I close?
Yeah, maybe on that roof.
On the other side.
Yeah. Because if you... There's your gun.
Let's put that away.
Hold square... Well, you'll need it in a second. To fight someone. Oh, that's a storm drain. That's it. It's up there. Yeah. See the little... Oh, can you jump on that thing?
Let's see. Back up. Dude, I'm stuck somewhere.
Are you talking to people in chat?
I'm trying to get that skull. I'm going to get my numbers in case things.
Oh, okay, great.
I'm going to backwards. What have I done?
Can you go...
Good.
Stuck. Here we go.
Can you jump out of this?
Let's see.
Okay, yeah, good. But that's it. If you can get up there somehow. I don't think you can jump on that thing.
That's a little high. Huh?
Fallout doesn't have... Oh, but that thing. Maybe on that little mushroom you can get up. Blamp.
Yeah.
Blamp. Dang it.
Trying to jump, double jump, maybe up here.
And then over there.
Over here.
There you go.
See.
And then onto the roof.
Oh
my
gosh. Craptastic.
Oh my gosh.
Classic.
This is the new Mario game called Fallout, where you try to jump from platform to platform.
Oh my gosh. Insanity.
Maybe there's a... Is that a ramp? Follow this ramp. I bet you can get up to the scaffolding somehow. To the left, maybe? To the wrong. See if there's a ramp. No. Oh, there we go. Excellent.
Oh my gosh!
What happened?
Oh my gosh!
What?
You guys!
What?
I don't know if this hasn't been popping up, maybe because there's so much, but thank you to Ashley Hood, who donated $5.
What?
Thank you, Ashley!
Ashley
Hood, that's
wow.
Amazing. Thank you to Juliet Jimenez for another $5.
Thank you, Juliet.
Imagine if I was actually playing well.
Me. Thank you to Lauren McFadden for $5 donation.
Thank you, Lauren.
Lauren, that's awesome. Bronwyn Durant.
What? What is this? Wow.
By the way, I'm calling out names. Maybe I should. It doesn't show me
what their screen name is.
Yes.
You're giving out their PayPal info.
I'm so sorry.
Password,
I've ruined everything.
8265437.
So anyway, you guys, I'm so appreciate this. And especially Wow, Jordan B. I won't say your last name. $50 donation.
$50
donation.
What? Wow, this is insane.
That's so crazy.
Stolen credit cards?
Yeah! Guys, thank you so much. That's crazy. We had no idea.
I don't believe this right now.
Yes,
no,
you can walk across that. No, you can walk across that thing.
That's what
yeah.
I'm saying. I'm not even jump.
Robbie is in a box of gratitude that is swallowing him up.
His heart has become... does he have a sickness? What's happening?
And you can make it to that storm drain right there.
This one right
Kellogg
here?
Has made it!
Oh, yeah.
Two Kellogg's. You can look down at it and press A, whatever A is.
Open.
I know, I'm not familiar with Xbox. It's tough for me, too.
Yeah, me neither.
Okay. So you are familiar. What is your video game history? What games have you played?
Well...
What games have you directed?
Oh, dear God. That goes back a ways.
Especially the NDA ones. They're not going to tell anybody. So we're going to talk about the ones that are coming out
next year.
Let's talk about the ending of the Gladio DLC. Sure. It's going to be amazing. Maybe put on your quest marker. Oh, we do have a... Oh, it's not... Oh, so actually what happened was I created this new character, and in 2 hours I leveled him up and just walked straight to Fort Hagen. So there's no quest marker right now. We're just going straight after Kellogg. That's how it's working for this one.
Jordan B. Fujoshi. Fujoshii.
Wow. Did you see that?
What?
Did you see where it just turned into Waterworld for a second?
No.
It glitched out like crazy.
Wait, we'll see it on the stream. So watch the stream.
No, it already... Oh.
Yeah, wait.
No,
oh,
I think
no,
it already happened. It already happened. Okay, what were you saying?
Fujoshii is who donated $50. They called it out on.
So we should not be reading their real names.
Yes.
We should be reading their
screen
names. I don't know why it doesn't pop up, you guys.
PayPal and stuff.
Figure that out, yeah.
You don't need to talk about that.
Well, here's. I'll just call out first name and last initial. No?
I don't know.
Am I taunting me right now? First name and last initial. That's always good.
Yeah, is that okay? That's not crazy.
Yeah.
Okay. Great.
Yeah, Rebecca E.
Rebecca E.
Thank you for a $10 donation.
Wow, that's insane.
That's so right. We told them that with these donations, we're buying better gear, better mics, better camera, better setup, better greens. We're gonna have a green screen. It's gonna.
We want to travel with this show to all the conventions as well.
We're traveling because on Friday we go to a lot of conventions, and so. On Fridays, it's tough for us to put this together, but hopefully we can, you know, set it all up to where we can organize it with the conventions, and it'll be great. Every Friday we'll have a stream, hopefully. What else?
Well, he actually made it inside,
inside
for a little bit.
Great.
So keep wandering around the rooms. Eventually you're going to come on some robots. I cleared out some of them beforehand, there's going to be a lot of them as you make your way down into this. There's the dead robots there.
I'm sorry, I have to keep going with this because we're getting some more stuff, so I'll interrupt you every time.
Yeah, go. Wow.
Gwendolyn M.
Gwendolyn,
thank you so much. $5 donation. Carly Price.
Carly Price.
Oh, come on now.
Carly.
Wait, we already saw
Carly. It's not Carly Price. That was her last initial.
That was her maiden name. Now known as something different.
Weird. Carly
B. You're on warning right now, Max. Max M.
Max M.
Thank you, Carly, for a $20 donation.
Wow.
Thank you.
Get that closer to the microphone. Get that closer.
Keep going down?
Yeah, keep going down.
Whole lot of excitement here.
There's a whole lot of nothing going on here.
That's very kind of you.
Yeah, no worries. Yeah, just a little, just to be able to walk around. Keep looking down. Oh, go through that door.
So make this up.
That looks like something.
Oh, yeah.
Not bad. You've got dog meat to help you, too. What does that sound mean?
It's the same thing. Don P., thank you for $20.
Thank you, Don.
Another one. Evidently.
Wait, so Keith is just kicking ass.
Another one.
Kick a ass.
Carissa B.
Carissa B.
Hey!
$20.
So Keith knows Carissa.
I might know Carissa.
How do you know Carissa?
Carissa, man, she is a hero of mine.
She brought me to PAX East, and she made me a Thane costume, which I wore and did cosplay as Thane. Similar to what you're doing here.
This is, we're talking about the same Carissa?
Carissa B.
Yes, she's awesome.
I believe she was.
This person?
Put my readers on and she... Yes.
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 That's amazing.
She's spectacular.
Paya.
She made the whole mask of Thane mask. She made the whole suit and we went out and...
You got to cosplay as your own character, which is, that's very rare.
Pia or Paya R, thank you for a $20 donation.
Is that gonna happen?
Every single time.
Farley D, thank you for a $5 donation.
Goodness gracious.
Amanda L, we know Amanda L, don't we? Either way, Amanda L, $20 is so appreciated.
Amanda, thank you so much.
Wow.
I don't know that. There's so many. These are real names. Yeah. These are real people's names and addresses. So Amanda L lives at.
Stephanie G.
Stephanie G.
Your
$5
donation is.
Which could be her real name.
Yes. So cool.
And or.
Oh my gosh, so you just hit a landmine. So currently you've lost both your legs. But if you press,
but it's gonna be fine.
Do you know how to open your Pip-Boy?
Don't be panic.
Pip-Boy is B.
Yeah.
And then
go down to aid. So I think it'll be like two rights. Yeah. Oops. Perfect. And then eat some grilled rat roach. Eat a carrot. Eat some bloat fly.
Okay. So why don't you? What
mole
are you?
Rat.
Mole rat.
What's happening? He's eating things right now for health.
I am.
Yes.
Pork and beans. Does
it's
that
growing
mean?
My legs back, dude. They're growing.
Oh, right. You
my
actually,
legs
so
back.
Actually, if they you don't. Are crippled, you do have to use a stim pack. So you have to use a stim pack to clear that. Not just eating food. So it's in alphabetical order, so you keep going down.
After R,
there
I guess?
Yeah,
yeah,
there you go. So use one and you're good to go.
I should be good to go.
You have both your legs back.
That's amazing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Makes me glad I lived this long.
It's a post-apocalyptic future. It's great.
It
okay, so you
watch out for the mines.
Yeah. Watch out for the mines. You're making your way through. You're going to
sure
some institute robots.
Oh, crap.
Oh, that's a turret.
Yes.
So, do you also know how to use bats? The thing where you don't
actually
where is have
that?
To aim?
Which one is it? If it's one of those. Yeah, I think it's this button. No.
Yeah, yeah, that. Whatever you just pressed.
Yeah.
But you have to go up to an enemy.
I'm trying to.
Oh.
I can't move while it's on.
Yeah. Get out. Yeah.
I thought I had. Return
one?
Is B.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Yeah, there you go.
Now I got to try to do this.
Yeah, get it in your sights. I forget what it is.
I thought I had it.
That's bats on.
Nope, that's not it.
I think it's left button.
Yeah, there you go. So you have a 92% chance of hitting it in the body, so just press trigger a bunch of times. And then, okay.
Okay.
Is A. Bam.
Oh.
Hey,
so you
now.
Don't actually have to aim. That's why Fallout's the best game ever.
It is
it's
pretty
just
good.
Great. It's just,
you can aim if you want.
You can
and
if you're hardcore like Max.
So it's the L1 button if you were playing on a PS4.
Yeah, right.
Check.
Yeah. We will be playing on a PS4 later, so don't worry, guys.
What?
Yeah. It'll be more in familiar territory. Oh, someone. There's an Insta guy.
Nice. So I can do that.
And the best is if your dog is back, you're all good. And once you've killed a guy, just click save.
Oh man, it's not looking good.
What's up?
Just hang on a second.
Okay. We have a big announcement to make in a second.
While I'm dying.
While you're dying. Get out of this and run away.
Alright.
So yeah, press B a bunch of times. And just get out. And then, take stim pack.
Aid
again.
Aid. Aid up there.
I'm gonna. Okay.
Okay. Are we ready for the announcement?
We gotta take some breaks. I mean, there's.
Sure.
There's a lot more. We gotta take some breaks to announce some people.
Okay.
So, Christy G. $5. Awesome.
Thank you, Christy
G. Me. Johnny LD. I'll say. $5 donation.
Thank you, Johnny.
Super cool. Heidi S. $15. It's great.
Heidi, thank you.
We love it. Daphne G.A.
Thank you.
$10.
Sweet.
So cool.
I wish we knew
they
their...
just keep little thing that's just
Mary.
Oh, yeah.
Mary R. We all know Mary R. I don't know if I want I can say, but that's the one. That's the one. $30. We
Thank
love you,
you Mary.
Thank you.
Oh, Mary.
Mary, that's wonderful.
Unbelievable.
Kathleen H. $5. Super
Thank you,
cool.
Kathleen.
Catherine
Heigl.
Catherine Heigl.
Wow.
Not Catherine.
Didn't know she was a fan of Fallout.
And generous as hell, yeah.
Noel P. $5.
$5.
Thank you, Noel.
That's awesome. I hope I'm saying this right. Jolynn.
Yeah.
Jolynn G. $10.
Thank
you,
Jolynn.
Awesome, Jolynn.
Colleen W. $20.
Thank you,
wow.
Colleen.
Colleen.
Awesome.
We have to keep playing.
Okay, we'll keep.
No. We're gonna
move
the camera.
I know. Yeah, move the camera. Okay, so let's continue and we'll continue as we. Oh, you want to keep?
Oh,
going
I just took another
names?
One.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Okay. Corinne D. Corinne, you think that's pronounced Corinne?
Yes.
Corinne, $5. Thank you.
Thank you, Corinne.
That's awesome. Sarah B. $10. So cool.
Thank you, Sarah.
Margaret B. $10.
Thank you.
Are you guys related?
Come on.
Obviously not. Different,
obviously
different
not.
Last
when
names.
You actually look at their last name.
Crafted with Zeal.
Crafted with Zeal. Yeah, that's Scala's girlfriend.
Oh.
I think. Or is it Scala herself?
I don't even know if this is supposed to. I don't know if I should.
No,
Crafted with Z.
No, we know. Crafted with Zeal. She has an Etsy shop. She makes amazing merchandise. We met her
at AWA.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, Crafted with Zeal, $25.50.
Thank you so much.
Pretty
awesome.
Well.
There you go, synth leader down. Kellogg has killed the synth leader.
It's.
Means something.
This is insane.
That means
this
something.
Is insane,
all right,
guys.
Pause.
Okay,
I'll
got
pause.
It.
I just the synth leader really took it out of me.
Really took it out of you.
If you would just thank a couple of
all,
performers.
First of all, hang on. What is our viewer? We can't really tell, but we have about 1,200. Well, it says 1,200.
Million.
12 million
people are watching.
We have 12 million viewers right now.
Yeah,
what?
Give or take.
No, that's total over the course of lifetime.
Oh,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Crafted with Zeal is... just got a text from Scala. She says it's her. Thank
it's
you,
her.
Scala.
It is Scala. Thank you.
That's awesome. Scala Kitty who mods our channel.
She's amazing.
I cannot keep up with this. I think I've skipped... No, I haven't skipped. Do that one? Okay.
Jessica.
Guys... Jessica W. $500.
What? It's a typo. Take it back.
Yeah,
it back.
That was just a little.
We're in the morning.
Nice one, Robbie.
This is,
how does he do it?
Thank you. I don't
That's
know what
unreal.
To say other than thank you. We're gonna with this money.
There's a green screen right there.
We got
green
it.
Green
we already got
a green
screen.
Screen.
Yes.
That's amazing.
Thank you so much.
Don't
this
wear
is
that
crazy.
Shirt.
I can't wear this shirt.
Anymore.
Yes, good point, Keith. I cannot
shirt.
Wear green. No more green for the
Keith,
stream.
We gotta get you down because they start getting mad if there's not things happening on the screen.
Well, like,
that I do remember from last time.
Okay, well,
we'll
keep going with the game.
500,
sweet.
Jessica.
Jesus.
Thank you. I wish we knew what their usernames are. Those are usually more fun to say.
I know.
Yeah.
Let's see. How do I figure this out?
I don't go through there.
Let's see.
You can't go through there. You can't, I think you can take the
this
chains
door?
Off that door.
Yeah, so I was going to. That
yeah.
was my next.
So,
activate.
Do you. Are you, is he going to narrate? Well, yeah, no.
Who?
Once you get down there. So, Robbie's played the game. He knows what happens when you get down into the bunker. So, he's slowly making his way down into the bunker.
Am I going. Am I meant to go down even further?
Yes, I think even further, yeah. Because you're going down into this military bunker that Kellogg has built.
Right.
It's really scary. As you remember from all the visuals that they gave you when you were recording.
Oh yeah, those
yeah.
were really
a lot of great visuals.
Yeah, before so I could
Can
prep.
You talk about here's some questions that people might ask. What was your audition like? What was it like when you got the audition for Kellogg?
It was just like another, you know, this is just like another day in the life, you know. You
oh,
get these,
you don't want to go down there, you don't
No.
That's another
that's
exit to the place.
Oops. It's one of those things where, you know, you do so many auditions in a day or in a week that you just sort of forget, and then you get the booking, and they call you, and you show up, and then the crazy thing about it was the first time I'd ever sat down, but they put the NDA out in front of me, and I signed the NDA, and they said, this is a big gig. And I said, oh, really? What is it?
Is it great?
And they said, it's big.
So let's get started.
And that was it.
And then I went in, and there's, you know, there's a microphone and a music stand and a stack of scripts. And I think they gave me some direction that was really fun. It was just like, it's like a film noir.
Okay.
Type of a feel. And I was like, that's right in my wheelhouse. So
do
I
you
just...
know, there's a lot going on. What is going on?
Oh, you got questions for me?
Oh, okay. Robbie has questions for you. What Max is over there doing something with the technology, changing something on the stream. We don't even know.
It's probably something
telling a story.
Spectacular. But I didn't know. I just
you
I kept,
didn't know.
I kept showing up, and they would have some more stuff for me to read.
How many times did you go in for this guy?
It was over the course of a year and a half, probably.
Eight, ten. That is a lot because he doesn't have that.
He doesn't
much
have that. Maybe
it was
less. Maybe it's more like six. I don't know. Hard to know. Over a year and a half.
Did they do it?
You
in,
sort of
in yeah.
You
did
forget.
They do it in order of what happened in the game, or was it all
no,
out of sequence?
No, it was all out of sequence.
Gotcha.
So no, I think I stole your baby and killed your spouse like
last.
Toward the end.
Okay, gotcha. Bummer. Okay, another broken leg. We do a stim pack. No worries.
The leg just grows right
Let's
back.
Get some good stuff out of this.
Loading up.
Yeah. So you can take Fallout is one of my favorite games because it's not about aiming. It's about slowly going through and just looting stuff and crafting stuff and
you
not
like
being seen.
You should tell
aspect.
You a lot about Ray's personality.
Yeah, it's all about a very sneaky person.
I
want to
loot.
I like doing this.
I want to steal stuff when no one's looking.
Yeah, exactly. Now, I don't remember. This is where you got. Okay, here we go. Here we go. There we go. We keep going down this hall. And then here's some dead people. But they're like really dead people.
Maybe they've got something on them.
Yeah. And so when you did this game and it came out, did... What was the reception? Do you know much about your character? How people view him? Did you get a lot of fans following?
You know, it's interesting because I didn't really. I mean, I put it out there and I was really excited about it when it came out. Thrilled to be a part of it. Like I said, I checked in on some of the stuff that I'd recorded just to see what the story was.
Yeah. Did
picked
you know
up
what your
copy
character
of the game,
looked like?
Started playing. No.
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 Wow.
This is also the first game I did where I did facial capture.
Oh.
So I think some of this stuff is actually, yeah. I showed up.
Seriously?
Yeah. I showed up one day and they had a guy there from that had worked on Avatar who put all the little dots on my face.
Wow.
And then I
did,
which was a trip because no one told me again when I was going in. Oh, by the way, you're going to be suited up.
Wow.
And it's the crazy helmet with the... With the camera out here,
while
with the lights that are going on.
Wow.
And so I started to think, like, well, this is cool because I can move. I knew I could move around with it because it was stationary and it was going to track me. But what I didn't take into consideration was the mic and the camera at the same time.
Well, did
was
you have to...
Was a trippy thing to get used to.
So it wasn't... I've done one where I had a...
Sometimes you have the mics planted here.
Where you don't have to worry about where you
and
face.
You can just be wherever you
but
want.
But yours,
to be.
You had a face
nope.
camera
big
and a
Neumann
thing.
In front of, just like this.
Okay,
in
gotcha.
In front of my face with this thing
with
out
the
to
camera
here.
On it. Wow, that's nuts.
So it was. It was a little tricky because you start to think.
Do you feel? You feel
technically
like your performance came out badly because of that.
That's why.
That's why it was
that's
such
why
a bad
I
performance.
Yeah. So now that we've got the excuses out.
Who messed up the most in the booth on Final Fantasy 15? Is one of the questions. And you can write, if you can write down their the username too. It's great, we can shout them out.
That'd be me.
You messed up the most?
Well, I was there every day for 6 months.
So,
I was like, okay, so you're madly in love. And so I really want to make sure that you get that across. And then Dan would be like,
no,
these guys,
no,
are,
these guys
they
are not
hate
in love.
Their, they, hate they hate their guts.
I don't know why
okay,
I can't
just one
find
thing.
Where to go next. I'm lost in
but
this
the,
place. I don't
actors,
know what the heck
I don't
happened.
Even, I don't even think about that. It's really funny.
Are we not able to... We need to ask the stream. Are we not able to go down because I didn't do this the proper way and I just went straight to Kellogg without going through the motions?
Oh.
Because I can't find... the way down. Because this is it. We need to go down, but I did not play through the game the way you're supposed to. I just kind of went straight for Kellogg. So it might be that the game is not letting us. So we'll wait 20 seconds.
Sure.
And then the stream will probably have an answer. And then if that's the case, we will not see Kellogg today. Or we can play another 10 hours of Fallout.
We can just run around here.
Finally we get there, yeah.
Which would be okay with you.
Max,
you're a
you
fan.
Can talk. You haven't lost your voice.
I'm sorry. I keep whispering.
I was like, is that okay?
Mission. So we don't have... All I did, I was at Max's. I start a new character, which is Kellogg. It looks like him. It acts like him. It's just amazing. Started him from scratch. There is no quest. I just went straight to where Kellogg is.
Can't do it.
You can't go straight to Kellogg.
No, you gotta, like, go through the quest, level up.
Robbie says, what? You have to go through the quest. It's not far.
I can go all the way to Diamond City and rescue Nick. No, I gotta rescue Nick Valentine. All right, fine. We're on very easy. We're just gonna freaking beat the crap out of this game. Full steam ahead.
Let's go!
And then Keith is gonna answer a million questions. So I guess that's how it'll be. So I'll go really, really fast through the game. Eventually we'll make it to Kellogg. We might be able to get it pretty fast. Right now we're in a bit of a maze, but it's gonna be okay. We're gonna have a lot of questions being asked as people go. So, but really, who messed up in the booth out of the four of us?
I don't know.
Who is the worst? Who is the hardest to work
who
with?
Who was the hardest to work with?
Yeah. Yeah.
That's a terrible question. To make me choose.
Guys,
how did you come up with
Bat Boy? Oh, that's a good story. Or Bat Boy. You want to hear about Bat Boy? Oh.
Wait, I have a question.
Yes.
I have a, sorry, real quick. Logistics question. Apparently, we're supposed to see donations, usernames in Streamlabs. But it says there are no donations.
So they're not real. We take back all of our congratulations!
$500 down the tubes.
Yeah.
Green screen dream shattered.
That can't be Carissa.
I believe Carissa donated.
That cannot be the case.
But in Streamlabs it says no, which is this is like some software that goes with Twitch.
So Garrett, if you're watching, I'm sure you are. What's going on?
So we have that. So let's talk about Bat Boy.
Let's talk about Bat Boy.
We're streaming Bat Boy on Xbox One right now. This is we're on the final chapter of Bat Boy. What was your first idea?
I was shooting a movie out in the Mojave Desert, and I'd gone out one day to pick up a pack of smokes and some snacks and stuff. And on the rack was the Weekly World News with the Bat Child found in cave.
Wow.
So I picked it up. I'd always had fun reading the Weekly World News in college when we would do tech and stuff. You know, just bring the Weekly World News and you read it out loud. It's hysterical. So I took it back to the set and we started reading about Bat Boy. And now the thing about this movie was we had one corporate sponsor, which was Budweiser.
They wanted just to make a small budget film?
We were doing a small budget film, and our producer had sent out, like anybody wanted to do product placement, Budweiser bit, sent us 24 cases of beer to the Mojave
Enough
Desert.
To make a movie.
He said, that'll work.
That'll work. Yeah. So after we'd shoot, we'd sit around the campfire and, you know, always had a ukulele or a guitar and a little keyboard, and we just started making up Bat Boy songs. And that became like a party favor. When we would throw parties, everyone would ask, are you going to sing Bat Boy? Are you going to sing Bat Boy? And we would just get around the piano and just make shit up. And we did this for about 2 years.
What?
For about 2 years this went on. We didn't think anything of it. And then one day, we're sitting on my front porch with Brian Fleming, who is my partner, who also wrote and directed the movie that I was in. And I said, if we wanted to make this into a real musical, how would we do that? And Brian, who's ever the practical one, said, well, we gotta get the rights first.
To the Bat Boy?
Yeah.
To the Bat Boy.
We have to get the rights.
Who is
if you
the
look
Bat
on the cover of the Weekly Word News, it says Bat Boy, trademark.
Wow.
Found in cave. So I was a member of the Actors Gang Theater Company. Here he comes. And we had a pretty kick-ass board of directors at that time. Robin Williams, Alfre Woodard, Buck Henry, etc. On Actors Gang letterhead, I just typed a letter to the Weekly World News that said, hey, listen, we'd like to license the rights to this character, and we don't have any money. We're just doing a little 99-seat theater here in L.A. We'll give you $1 to make it a real thing. Would you be willing to do that? And they said, sure.
Wow.
So we sent them a buck. And they gave us the rights to do Bat Boy.
Oh my gosh.
And we did it we opened Halloween night in 1987.
1997, Halloween, at the Actors Gang, 41-seat theater.
Wow. Well, how long did it take you to write it? From that $1 purchasing of the rights?
I think we started in earnest at the beginning of 96, and we did a draft of a treatment of the show where Batboy becomes a rock star, but he gets brought down by his need for puppy blood backstage. So it was kind of an Elvis story because we were both into a great, great, great documentary called This Is Elvis, where Kurt Russell, I think, does the voice of Elvis, and it's sort of this weird documentary of Elvis, but it really goes into how Colonel Tom Parker was Elvis's downfall, essentially.
Oh, the down! Wow.
So we made the villain. We named him Thomas Parker. That's where that came from.
That's
from
really cool.
Colonel Tom Parker, and he was a spiritual advisor in the rock and roll Batboy version. But we went in and read that treatment to a group of friends, and it bombed. So we went back to the drawing board. And
you've never written a musical before?
No.
You had no experience?
No.
But you knew you wanted to write about Batboy because you paid your hard-earned money for
it. Well, Batboy had provided 2 years of entertainment.
Yes,
at
that's
parties.
True.
I mean, we knew it was going to work.
There was already a relationship.
There was already a deep relationship. So, it was a tricky... Yeah, it was a very interesting time. So we scrapped that, and then I was looking at Joseph Campbell.
I got orders not to let you.
And Brian was really into Richard Dawkins, evolutionary psychology, and evolutionary biology. And so the two of those sort of meshed. We meshed together everything that we were reading and exploring and going through to give the story of a half-bat, half-boy a total mythopoetic treatment. So we would... We always imagine that Batboy sort of lives in the pantheon of the great gods and heroes of literature. And we just thought it would be hysterical to have a character from the dumpiest tabloid on the rack and take that character and elevate
him
to the highest.
Of the hero.
Right.
The hero myth.
Right.
That is amazing.
So that was the sweet spot. That was the sweet spot. Is this part of the game where you have to just get dizzy?
This is part where I wait for the voice actors to say their lines.
I just got here.
This is the part of the game that everyone skips. Uh-huh. This is actually really cool. This is because Fallout, they don't have a lot of character animation. They just kind of stand there.
Right.
But this is one of the few instances where there's a lot going on, and it's nice.
Jeez,
they seem a little more human, which is good.
That was something I noticed too when I was playing through. I was like, look at the video.
Yes, it is very.
That was where they could make the world so.
That's where they could make 700 hours worth of content. I think Yuri Lowenthal's around here. I think Yuri is this guy.
That guy looks like.
You're Sullivan, right?
So, you're that traitor Piper was talking about.
Piper, I think it's Yuri? I think.
I'm not sure.
Officer?
Did you do,
the level of dishonesty in that paper of yours.
I'll have that printer scrap for parts.
I don't remember. I might have done a couple of ancillaries. I think I might have done one or two.
Maybe you.
Yeah, I don't remember what they are. Kellogg was so much fun. Because the mayor's
threatened to throw free speech in the dumpster. We don't even have access to the stream. This is just basically
always believed in freedom of the press.
And he's sitting.
I just love that.
That it looks exactly like
the character. It's really funny.
We also
expecting it to sound like
right. Yeah, it's weird that it's Brian's voice that comes out.
Welcome to the great green jewel of the Commonwealth.
When you went in for Kellogg, did they work on the voice very much, or was it just
he's back?
What you ended up being? Here's our mime.
Don't let this.
Did they work on the voice?
Nope.
Okay.
Did you just film that to yellow?
Once I got in, and
yes,
they told me it was sort of film noir.
I'm sure your city's great.
That just
and that was it. Can you talk about Thane Creos? What was that like? That audition process.
That was the same sort of thing. Oh, you know what's funny? I was at a dinner party.
An infant boy.
At my friend Tom Zender's house, and Tom runs a studio here called Rocket Sound.
Well, don't
we were at his house having dinner, and I was like, "Oh shit, I forgot this audition."
I hope so.
That I have to do, And I've had enough of this, Piper.
Setting up your studio
from now on,
and
you and that
doing this
little sister of yours.
So I went into his studio.
Yeah,
and
this is at Rocket Sound where we were.
Not Rocket Sound. I'm sorry. His Vapor Trail Pro. He has a rocket.
Mayor McDonald.
Oh, okay.
Vapor Trail. Sorry about that. Sorry, Tom. Both Toms, Zender and Hayes.
He doesn't think they're watching. Yeah, Tom Hayes isn't watching. He's not on Twitch all the time.
How could he not be? So we went out into his studio and I did a couple takes and he gave me a little bit of direction, which was good. And then he totally tweaked the audition with all of his little mess. And he said, you know what? Because if you book this thing, you got to take me out to lunch.
Whoa.
And I was
because he gave you all this direction.
I said, no problem. It was worth, you know, being in his studio. He fired everything up and he recorded me. And it was like 4 months later that I got the call that I booked it. Because they'd actually cast somebody else, and I guess didn't work out for whatever reason, and they recast with me. And there was some confusion on the webs about, like, because there was some demo stuff that had been released.
Was it
with another
different
actor
from you? Was it a lot different?
It was a little different.
Wow, okay.
And people noticed the difference. But then I got to work with the great Ginny McSwain.
Another stay coming in from the ring.
She and I are from the same cloth.
Yeah.
We both came up from the theater.
I know you must
be both
busy,
have the same sort of,
much of your time,
upbringing. Same sort
Max,
of.
Are you pinching my face? Or Robbie,
the detective,
is this what
he's
is
gone.
Going on?
Squishing
my head. Not bad.
Don't worry. I can help. Tell me what happened.
Come and get me.
Max also sounds very
Rick
distraught in the other.
Days.
Hey, Ray?
Yes.
Can you give me your loans, gang?
No, it's just Keith and a mute.
You have the heck? You have to hear a second.
There's an old ball
just,
there
the,
that he uses.
Just take away for 1 second.
I told Nick he was walking into a
Julie is also here.
Just a lot of talking. Oh, gee, the mime! You ever touched one? You ever hold one of those before? Robbie has been on vocal rest for how many weeks?
I don't know much about
2 weeks, and you've got how many more to go? Two more weeks to go, and so you need both hands. How many video games have you played in the last 2 weeks? what day is it? It's like 10, 12.
He's amazing.
Which tea is that? Don't speak. Is it this one? Gross.
It's mine, tea. Are you okay, honey?
Coat?
What should we do? Let's see.
No way am I getting mixed up in this.
Looking out for yourself, huh?
Wow. They should have given Courtney Taylor.
Even the character
like
looks
like
charged across the Commonwealth of Fighting.
Yeah. That's crazy. How does that work out?
Just go.
I know. Some good makeup.
It's appropriate that you're playing the one with the good makeup.
just got it distracted there for a second. Just a little.
I want to know about the puppy.
Oh, wait there.
He follows you about and helps you.
What's his name? Does he have a?
Yeah, you don't see. Okay, come
How
on,
many
Sharon.
Syllables?
Two syllables.
Two words.
Two syllables.
Second word. I'm with you. Bark? Speak? Things you can.
Dog?
Dog? Food? Meat?
Hey!
Doggy! Yeah, where's your thing to make me feel really good?
I can't do it. I don't know that.
So guys, also, always play charades with me. Super successful.
What am I doing?
You're getting dizzy again.
I'm getting dizzy.
Puppy.
Yeah, I'll go out there.
Well, there's a specific through line that we're heading for, though, right? Okay.
Yeah. I think we'll just.
This is my favorite part so far.
It is.
Yeah.
That was a dark, dark night.
Oh, also, I think we had discussed the fans being allowed to submit song requests for whistling.
The old whistle.
I don't know where. So the request line is off the comment, but with that in mind.
No, me and Gladys. Wait.
Apparently you have to wait until Final Fantasy.
Okay.
Although,
Everybody's gone.
I need to see you in a brown skirt.
I'm left all alone.
You are.
I've been left all alone.
It's so sad. There's no way for them to torture the guest who is now without protection. Who's now without any kind of defense.
I could run around too, but I have no idea what my goal is without Ray here to help me.
Well, see how lost you can get.
Yeah.
That's my personal favorite goal when playing these games.
Oh, Ray's back.
It's weird that Milo's not here.
It is weird.
Yeah.
A little fella.
Guys, well, we gotta explain what's going on. So, you folks out there, first of all, we're getting the donations business. We're getting all your donations. We need to sort out some PayPal issues, which we should have done before the stream, but we'll do it after the stream, and by next Friday, we'll have everything sorted out. We already have your guys' info, so it'll probably go through, and we'll be able to read your names next week, hopefully. It'll be fine.
Well, that'll all depend on whether or not Max can remember the rules that he makes for himself about reading names.
Oh, yes. I must remember.
It's not so much a PayPal issue.
First name, last initial. Also, Skylar's telling us to turn the sound on the game down.
Oh, the sound of the game down? That's fine.
So I can do that, I think, on the computer, right?
No, not on the computer. It's on the TV. It's messing with what they're hearing.
Oh,
double sound.
Their sound is right there.
Yeah. It's going straight through.
It's okay, guys.
No one panic.
It's falling apart.
The stream. We need the stream. We also Max, get on the stream. This is crazy.
Guys, we've gotten to a punch drunk place in a really, really short amount of time. Like that was impressive.
I feel like I'm in high school after 2 a.m.
Me, high school after midnight. I was like, oh my gosh, I've done all my homework. I have to go to bed now.
Were you guys answering questions or still talking about Thane? What happened? What was going on?
Thane was just, me and Ginny would just usually spend about an hour talking about theater stories.
then we'd
always probably get to work. We should probably get some work.
And then you just went right.
And then we would just go right.
It wasn't a big deal. Okay.
And she was great. I mean, I really, really loved you.
Miss?
Nick's still gone.
You can't beat someone who's got chops like that.
I'll find him. You have my word.
That clear and concise.
Nick should be used to this.
How much of Thane is your own voice and how much of it is processed?
Trench coat get up.
It's
please hurry.
It's processed.
Yeah.
But it's mostly me.
That's cool.
It's mostly me.
Is it
I can't do this.
Yeah, can you just do it right now? That's basically his place.
Yeah, it's just... Ginny would always say, find the sweet spot. So, that's kind of the sweet spot for Thane.
Not bad. You know, he's sexy. He's the sexy one.
He was built. That's why they created him.
Yeah, because there were too many female romanceable aliens. And they were like, where are the male romanceable aliens?
Right.
Yeah.
Where's the one that the girl gamers will go after?
Okay, finally we made it to...
Dun.
All right, look. Robbie.
Here it comes.
Hang on, he's getting a magic trick.
What?
Oh!
Robbie, come here.
Aren't you doing that? Are you still studying?
Robbie, okay, so now we made it to where we're going to find Nick Valentine. We're going to go through the entire vault. Then we're going to have to go through the whole thing where you, like, find out about Kellogg and who he is and, like, your dog sniffs for all the stuff. Then we're going to have to go all the way to Forhagen. Or we could just start playing Final Fantasy 15, which is, I think, what people want. Also, where's the stream? Why can't we read the comments? Please, somebody, get on the comments.
Well, hang on. So,
okay.
So Scala is saying it's not double sound. It's they're having trouble hearing over the gameplay.
Oh.
So I think I actually have to turn it down on the
OBS.
All this talking that I've been doing has been for naught.
Has been for
naught.
They didn't hear a single thing.
Whoa.
So
no, that's
today.
Why they know there's a problem, because they're straining to hear every word.
All right, so
they don't
save
miss
this
it.
For now.
I'll just get close, and we'll do some, I'll do a little Thane.
Uh-oh.
Like, close mic in it. Give it that. Is that better?
We need,
listen up, ladies.
Call it out.
To,
just get close.
PS4.
That's the way it works.
PS4.
Yes.
No, I'm gonna switch over. It's like...
No, but it's really easy. All you have to do is change one cable.
All you have to do is change everything. It's
okay.
Fine.
One simple cable.
I hope we don't lose you.
It's just one cable.
Scala says much better. I turned it down.
Great. We'll play Final Fantasy 15, which is what they came here for.
Okay.
Here we go.
That was fun, though.
It's just one thing. Yes.
That was fun. I enjoyed
myself.
You're
going to come back again when Robbie can speak again.
Yeah.
You're going to be able to.
Yeah.
And then we'll have Kellogg really queued up, and you'll be able to see what it is. And Kellogg will finally be able to.
You got me excited about going back to the game. Going back to Fallout 4. It's one of those ones where I went through, and then I got to a spot where I got stuck, and I just sort of put it aside. And with kids and work and everything, video games just tend to sort of, if I'm not on it, they just slip down.
Because it's so many hours.
Oh, so many hours.
Yeah. No, it's crazy.
Because, like I said, I started with Pong, and I used to go to the Payless drugstore near my house, and they had the Pong set up on the TVs in the back of the store, and they had...
You realize you're spending 3 hours in the drugstore?
Had double. You could play doubles, which was essentially just two paddles on each side that went up and down. And I'd love to get the ball, the little Pong ball, in between the two front paddles. And it would just go, and I would just leave it and leave the store. And sometimes I get three or four of them going, and I get them all set up like that.
Get that man back here.
But the first console I bought was a ColecoVision, way back in the day. It's probably like 82, 83.
No voices in that.
None. No. Absolutely zero. Close. Nope. Pre-VO. And then...
And yes, you can still ask questions for Keith, guys. I'm on the chat since nobody else is...
Seems to.
Robbie left. He's doing magic tricks. I don't know what happened.
He's reapplying his makeup.
Robbie's rehearsing his next mind-blowing card
Also,
stunt.
They're shipping Max B, which I guess is Max and Robbie. That's what your ship is. The Max and Robbie ship.
Yeah.
Oh, Fandom Side actually has a ColecoVision, so he knows what you're talking about.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
It was great. There was some weird games on that thing. There was a BC game that we used to play. Remember BC the comic?
Yes, Johnny Hart's BC. Yeah.
And it was a little guy on his little wheel that he stood on, and you had to take him through all these little...
Wow, that's insane.
It was a very Mario Brothers-esque, very side-action scroller. Nice.
Okay, so Robbie has some things to distract you with while we're setting up the stream again. But it looks like we are going through. Julia's going to go. By the way, Julia, I wasn't reading all the comments, but people are fans of you.
Really?
Yeah, there were a lot of like,
say
Julia.
When? Okay, he's going to...
Max, we're very busy talking about me right now.
Right now we're going to say goodbye to Julia.
Bye, guys.
Julia, say goodbye.
Bye, Julia.
I'm stuck behind Robbie's head, but bye!
Okay, and now people are really excited for more magic with Robbie.
Yay!
Oh, how could you not be?
Just say when.
Robbie is...
Say when.
Queen of Diamonds.
Is it? It's a Queen of Diamonds! He said Queen of Diamonds, and it was a Queen of... You couldn't hear him say Queen of Diamonds.
Well, that's the benefit of the mime. No, I said.
A lot of people are saying goodbye to you, Julia.
Oh, guys, that's so cool.
They're
Thank
very
you.
Excited. Robbie's looking fine, even as a mime.
Whoa.
A lot of great stuff in here.
Wait, which he's fine.
Nice that it rhymes.
Yes. Okay, we're getting set
one
up.
More time.
It looks like things are going okay.
Terribly. Things are really bad right now.
Things are going really poorly. We are switching. Milo's doing fine. We're at Max's house right now. M's house. And doing stuff.
Julia.
Stuff is happening. Oh, people really want you to stay, Julia.
Well, I can't leave if you love me that much.
Who needs
selfish.
Magic Mike when we have Magic Robbie?
Dude, that'll okay, reverse. Can we please have a vote for Robbie to do the dance from Magic Mike? Because I have that song on my iPod.
So we have a request for some uke.
Oh, you do?
So we do have a ukulele.
I do.
How long have you been playing ukulele?
Oh, a while.
A couple
while.
Hours?
A couple hours. I started this afternoon.
Yeah, not bad.
Not bad. I'm working on it.
Did you... Are we going to do... Oh, people are... Oh, we're excited. Oh, yes, 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 yes. Oh, no, this is for Robbie dancing.
Oh,
we haven't gotten
20
to the
seconds
part.
Late.
We're 20 All right. seconds late.
Good night, everybody.
Good
Thanks
night,
for coming.
Everybody.
All
right, I'm taking the ukulele. Robbie can dance to the ukulele.
But come on, we should do me and Gladio.
Let Julia Macklemore stay. Keith, okay. Wait, we have too many things for Keith and... No, we have dancing and ukulele. They're going crazy. Uke plus Robbie dance.
Yes,
Robbie dance.
That was my
ukulele,
idea, yes.
Robbie ukulele.
Oh!
Yes! Oh, it's so good! Keep going! You didn't hurt your hip bone, you hurt your throat!
It hurts your
We're all up to it. Gonna show you what it's all about, yeah. Don't have to be rich to be my girl. Don't have to be cool to rule my world. No particular sign I'm compatible with. Just want your extra time and your kiss.
Oh, yeah.
You have a lot of fans out there. Says typical gamer porn. 1,000 out of 10 ukulele. So awesome, so good. Keythe, holy crap, woo, bravo. It's too much, I can't read it! It's a 10! Oh, ukulele, yes, Keythe, yes,
broke
Keith,
the
oh,
internet!
So, we need. I can't leave because you can't talk. Robbie. Keythe and Robbie are going to do some. Oh, you're going to whistle the chocobo theme. We have. We have Chocobo. Okay. I'm gonna go help.
I don't know if they can hear this, but. Wait for it. The meltdown on the uke for the end. Here we go, from here.
This is amazing.
Year, but I haven't played it. And when Robbie said, when I saw him on Tuesday, he was like, "You still know that Chocobo song?" I was like, "I'll work it up. I'll work it up. I'll play it much better now." One more time. You gonna whistle it? All right. That's a nice little intro too. Yes.
Woo!
I got a sense to redeem myself after the first one.
So pure, Robbie, you're the coolest. I'm so blessed. This is literally so relaxing. Guys,
that's
I can't
incredible,
get enough.
Incredible, Keith. I did not know that.
Someone needs to make a CD.
I went out looking for a song. I was like, I need something to sort of, because I've been playing the same 30, 40 songs for years. And I was like, you get that place where you're like, I got to learn a new song.
Yeah.
And so I go to this the great website, Ukulele Hunt, which shortens to a very...
you cunt?
Yes.
Yeah, you cunt. I know you cunt.
UkuleleHunt.com. And they have all these great tabs and stuff. You can learn to play these songs. And the chocobo, it's called Aloha Chocobo. And it's right at the edge of my abilities as a ukulele player.
Wow.
And it still is. It's still a really tricky
song. Were you directing Final Fantasy 15 at this point?
Yeah, it was about a year ago.
So you knew chocobos and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah,
so
well,
like,
I knew the song.
This is
I knew
perfect.
The song, thanks to all
wow.
y'all and your...
That is amazing. That is crazy. Okay, okay. Wait, so now we have the PS4 open. And Julia, did you say there was a
is
request
it
or something?
There's a request for Keith to do his best impressions of the Final Fantasy 15 cast.
Okay, wait.
Oh,
I
no,
want this.
On, no.
I
yeah.
want this really bad.
Yeah.
So we're not all, we always record in isolation.
You do.
And Keith would read us in, if we didn't have someone, because we would go like in random order. Someone would go first for a conversation,
right.
And then we'd fill in the things. Sometimes it would be, I would go first or Rob would go first, whatever. And sometimes if you're going first, you don't hear anybody else. Is lines that come before yours.
Right.
So Keith would do impressions of what Ignis would sound like, what Gladio would sound like before you read in order to get acclimated to what the scene was. I never heard his Noctis impression because
no.
I was Noctis.
Right.
So I never knew what his sounded like. So I finally want to hear, what would you read in for all
so
of us?
So close to your voice. I mean, anyway, he's not that far off.
From
you.
Me.
He's
yeah.
a little bit
he's
pitched
a little,
up. But
yeah, he's a, yeah.
Just kind of in here and he's like, yeah, come on, let's go, you guys.
That's crazy.
No, I can't. My dad totally died. I'm a bit beside myself.
That's amazing. What does Robbie's Prompto sound like?
Prompto's tricky because Robbie's got the super high pipes.
Wonderful.
But it's always kind of up in here, you know? It's terrible, but that's what I would do. It'd be a little bit like...
What
come on,
your,
man, calm down.
What was your Gladio?
Gladio's probably the one that's closest to me.
Yeah.
So it's just sort of like, yeah, he's in here. Yeah. Gladio's always down in here. And
talk
like,
about cup noodles.
Quit it out. Cup noodles is really great.
Oh, a little known fact.
When the flavors all come together like that, it's just pure genius.
Keith also has all the tattoos.
That's true. It's almost Sam Elliott.
Sam Elliott.
He's got a little bit of Sam Elliott in there.
Yeah.
Just without the twang, you know.
What, your Ignis?
Ignis is just a basic upper-class British accent. Upper-class twit.
Very nice. Good Monty Python reference.
And what's your Treadfuria?
Yes, oh my God, Treadfuria?
Yeah, Treadfuria. Treadfuria was the character I played
Arden,
as Keith.
Arden.
We're asking about Treadfuria.
Oh my God.
Me.
Sorry.
Yeah, I don't think I directed
it.
You
didn't direct the movie.
I didn't direct that. Did I? Was that me?
Yeah, we're asking about Treadfuria, right, Max?
Yes.
Not that
now, do you... So, first of all, do you know about coming up with a new recipe? Do you know about the phenomenon
about
of
that.
Coming up?
Sure.
Do you know that line? You haven't played the game.
I have not.
So you don't know
so
what it is. Okay, okay. So you wouldn't know. You wouldn't be able to mimic the
He has like a little like high pitch, doesn't he, at the top?
It's like, I've come up with a new recipe. It's like that. That's it plays 100 times throughout the game. It's insane. But it's one of those things. There's so many of these catchphrases that we didn't know when we recorded.
Oh, how do you
know
they're going to become catchphrases?
Yeah, because it was just do 10 lines and see which one sticks.
I was talking to Adam on the phone the other day. I was like, do you even remember recording that line? He's like, mate, I don't. I don't, mate. I just don't. It's not in there.
You have requests for Arden and Luna.
Oh, perfect.
Darren DePaul.
Wow!
Always has Arden.
Arden
is so wonderful.
That's really good.
I've heard him a lot.
Yeah.
I've heard him a lot. Pick up the pace, Darren. Pick up the pace.
Because Darren doesn't come from...
He loves to just get so into it all.
He doesn't come from the dub world where you have
he's
to
great.
Stay in the time constraints. He's an actor.
He is.
So he's able to really, really enjoy himself.
Yeah. And it was just like,
because Chris, who plays Gladio, comes from promos. So he's used to, like, how many frames am I over?
Yeah.
And I'm like, six. He's like, okay. And then he just nails, puts six extra frames on there.
Yeah.
Darren is the opposite. Darren is a performance, you know? So I would just tell him, just do a little faster.
Yeah.
Try a little faster. He would never ask, like, how many frames, man?
Yeah. It wouldn't come from that well.
Not at all. He's just like, squeeze it in. And you also have, I mean, we had fantastic engineers from Dave Walsh and Z and Morgan Gerhard.
One is a friend of mine.
Who would trim the lines down to make them fit. If there was a pause that was too long, we could cut in the middle and squeeze it.
Change the breaths around.
Pause that was not, that was just enough to get in there and crack it open a little bit. We did a lot of that.
Yeah. Okay, I'm tapping. So you're tapping out.
I'm tapping out. You're in.
So we don't know how to, should we reset?
I don't necessarily want to, but yeah, I guess we
How do you
could.
Get the PS4 on there?
Well, yeah, because it's all hooked up. The PS4 is ready. For some reason, it's not, we're not able to switch midstream. Maybe the stream knows. The stream would be able to tell us, hey, what the heck is going on
stream.
With,
They want you to sing I Just Can't Wait to Be King from The Lion King.
I cannot sing. I'm not a singer. Oh, can you talk as Regis? I'll do a good Regis impression.
Dirty limericks.
Yes!
I don't... It's Jim Peary, and he's sort of in here.
Yeah.
That sort of, go, my son. Be free on the world.
Very
sort
good.
Of little Anthony Hopkins.
Oh, man. We shouldn't have brought you on the show. You're making us all look bad. It's terrible.
You have to understand, this was like 2 years of my life. I had plenty of time to get it in my head.
To really good, yeah. They're saying we should reset.
Reset.
Yeah, they're also asking for Noogle. Okay, there's so many requests. Julia, you are the best. You're not reading all the ones they're talking about. How you're the best.
She was on her way home. Wow. And she's
getting. It's so funny because they're getting so angry at me, but I'm the only one trying to fix it.
Yeah, you deserve some encouragement more than wrath.
Okay. It's on and off for the new stream. Okay.
Luna.
So we need to leave. We need to leave, and then we're going to come back immediately. Keith, I don't want to. We don't want to cut you off.
We love you, Max.
We're gonna.
I'm just fiddling about while you guys restart.
Fiddling about. Okay. So we are going to redo this. Yeah, because they're all still here. They're still watching.
Yeah. Okay, guys.
We're just not gonna be live for a second. Don't go anywhere. Don't start watching PewDiePie or anyone like that. We're gonna be here.
I could give him a suggestion.
Yeah.
PewDiePie.
Also, Max, use Google.
Use Google.
Gambate kudasai. Okay. Don't run away. We're resetting with hope to the future. Oh, that's what you said.
Yep.
Very well.
Thank you.
Good job. All right.
Here we go.
We'll see you in a
second.
Bye,
everybody.
We'll